What a mockery is this life of ours, cast forth in blood and pain from our mother's womb, most like an excrement in weeping showers of senseless tears, unreasoning, naked, dumb, a symbol of all weakness and the sun. Our very life is sufferance. Presently, our strong wings fight for standing upon the earth and the bare liberties of breathe and move. We crave the light of toil. We push, we strive, we jostle with the rest. We learn new courage, stifle our old fears, stand with stiff backs, take part in every toil. It may be that the love that we are blessed, it may be for a little space of years, we conquer fate and half forget our tears. Then fate strikes us. First our joys decay. Youth, with its pleasures, is a tale soon told. We grow a little poorer day by day. All friendships falter, love grows stranger and cold. In vain we shift our hearts to a new home and barter joy for joy, the less for less. We doubt our strength, our wisdom, and our gold. We stand alone as in a wilderness of doubts and terrors. Then, if we be wise, we make our terms with fate and arm the base, sell our life's last sad remnant forever. And it is wisdom thus to close our eyes. But for the foolish, those who cannot pray, what else remains of their dark horoscope but a tall tree and courage and a rope? And who shall tell what ignominy death has yet in store for us? What abject fear, even for the best of us? What fights for breath, what sobs, what supplications, what wild tears, what impotence of soul against despairs which blot out reason? The last trembling thought of each poor brain as dissolution rears is not of fair life lost, of heaven bought and glory won. It is not the thought of grief, of friends deserted, loving hearts which bleed, wives, sisters, children who around us weep. But only a mad clutching for relief, from physical pain, importunate nature's need. The search as for a womb where we may creep, back from the world to hide, perhaps to sleep.